Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul. I worship your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like worship your holy name. Bless you, time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship his holy name. Worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never. Worship your holy name.
thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness.
Peace that endures. Everyone, let's all stand. Whether we live unto the Lord. Whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we lived, whether we died, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ both died and rose again and revived, that he might be both the God of the dead and the living. Jesus said that I am the resurrection and I'm the life. He that believeth on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. God hath both raised up the Lord Jesus, and he will also raise us up at the last day. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and he shall stand on the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin that the worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh I shall see God. I shall see him for myself, and not another, and my eyes shall behold. Marvel not, for this that the hour is coming, when all that in the grave shall hear his voice, and they shall come forth, some to resurrection of life, and some to resurrection of contempt. This time they will turn over to Pastor Joseph.
Before we continue with this evening's celebration of the life of our sister Enola, I'm going to ask the congregation to kindly silence all mobile devices. Kindly silence all mobile devices. We invite at this time to the podium Pastor Rodlyn William, who will open us in prayer.
Let's all bow our head. Our most righteous and loving Father, who art in heaven, Lord, we thank you, Lord God, for this morning that you have granted unto us. Lord, we pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that you will remember these people, oh God, who came to make this funeral a funeral. God, we are giving thanks for your goodness, and we are giving thanks for your love. Lord, we know whatsoever you do, it is well done. And Lord, we ask you right now, God, as we look to you, from whence cometh our help. Our help cometh from the Lord, who maketh the heavens and the earth. Lord, we are praising you, Lord God, for your good works, because everything you did, it was good. And Lord, we pray, God, this morning, as we all have to sing and we have to, you know, say something about my sister, God. We know that she's gone and we will never see her again. Lord, this is a way that we only pass one time, but it's going to be another awakening where we won't be able to see one another, because that is going to be a day of judgment. But we pray, God, that whosoever in this church, God, that don't know you, that they will be able, God, to give you a chance in their life. Lord, she's gone. And Lord, we cannot see her again. But we know, God, that we will see you if we walk before you in the way that you will have us to be. We pray, God, that you will take every boy, every girl, ain't a hand. And Lord, we pray, God, that your protection will be upon us, God. God gave the preacher a word of revelation. Lord, even if it's to heal and cut and free, in the name of Jesus, bless the family. Bless us this morning. Bless those who are weeping and mourning. Dry their tears and help them that they will know we only pass this way one time. Take over, Lord God, and let it be a blessing in thy sight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Continue standing as you raise to him through all the changing scenes of life.
Through all the changing scenes of life, in trouble and in joy, the presence of my God shall stand.
first reading by Sharon Whitley.
Good morning. My condolences to all of my family members this morning. St. John chapter 14, from verse 1 to 6. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Here endeth the reading.
Thank you, Sister Williams. The verse of the song, O make trial of his love, experience will decide. How blessed are they, and only they, who in his truth confide. A very good reflection on the lesson that has been read. We all, at one point in time, must meet the God that caused us to be here. And the experience of the life we've lived will decide how our God receives us. At this time, we raise the hymn, When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. The hymn, When the Roll is Called Up Yonder.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and full. When the third Bible shall gather over like the other shore, and the world is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the world is called up yonder, and the world is called up yonder, when the world is falling under, I'll be there. On that bright and calm and morning, when the burning crash around, and the weary of his resurrection, I will so that one shall gather to the world beyond the sky. And the world is falling under, I'll be there. Oh,
Praise the Lord. You may be seated if you can. We invite at this time tribute by Pamela Carter. Tribute by Pamela Carter.
Good morning, church. My Auntie Wayne.
Glory be to God. Glory be to God, church. We have a poem for Auntie Wayne called Auntie Wayne. All right. Auntie Wayne, we thank you for everything. We appreciate it all, especially the food you would cook and bring. All know you would be making a mean sauce this Saturday morning. We could always ask if we needed anything. You always had our backs. We could count on you to come through whenever we needed that. I can hear you now telling me how much you love the skirt I send for you and that you love the blouse. I can hear you bragging saying, my niece is the only one that can shop for me. Auntie Ring, we remember when you used to dance and sing to your oldie goldie tunes on Sunday mornings. You would often make us die with laugh when you would joke about something, everything. We remember you would say you had two birthdays and we weren't sure which one to celebrate. Dwight and Dario will miss you dearly. Your dinner on Sundays and your breakfast talks in the mornings. You wouldn't like to see us mourn. You would look at all of us that crying and say, what are you crying for? Auntie Wayne, we love you. And you will be missed, but not forgotten. You will always be in our hearts, making us laugh about something. Your last words to me were, I hear you, Pam. And I will treasure that for the remainder of my life. Glory be to God.
I just wanted to say, I had a little joke. I don't know if it'll be funny to y'all, but I remember one time Stacy came home from school with her report card. And Rain was running her all around the table. When Rain looked at the card, she said, wait, we use a mice? That everything was weak. I should make it the mice sound. Weak, weak, weak. Use a mice. But rest in peace, Auntie. We will miss you. You were the life of the party. And you will forever be in our hearts.
Let us stand for the hymn When We All Get to Heaven. Stand for the hymn When We All Get to Heaven.
Oh,
Bless the name of the Lord. You may be seated if you can. At this time, we invite Althea Ellis, who will deliver the eulogy. Althea Ellis.
Good morning, everyone. Winona Carter, better known as Ring, was born on April 27, 1961, to the late William and Vanita Carter. She was the sister of Alvis, Osborne, Joel, Rodeline, Charles, Hamilton, Jessica, Pearson, Philip, and the late Gimel, Erla, and Angela Carter. She was the mother of two, Stacy Allen and the late Antonia Omar Carter, and grandmother of Shadane, Shadera, and Shadia Allen. All of us gathered here today would have known Ring in a variety of roles as a mother, an aunt, a cousin, and friend. Some of us would have known her better than others. It is my duty today to give you a glimpse into the life of Ring. Ring was known for her humorous personality. She loved to laugh and give jokes. She would say something that was really funny and was still able to keep a straight face, all the while leaving you cracking up and even in tears. She was a brave woman. What do I mean by that? She was never afraid of anyone. She always spoke her mind and would say, "The only one I am afraid of is God." If you doubted she was not afraid, her usual response was, "Wait, here, she got horns?" Ring had a stubborn streak with shoulder whenever she put her mind to do something. Good luck in getting her to change her mind. She had a way of bringing people and family together with her cooking skills. She had loved cooking. It was no surprise to us when she started to pursue jobs along that line, working at different restaurants and home, and also at Carrie's Bar. This was where her cooking skills were enhanced and a strong bond created between Ring and the owner of the bar, Joan. She would always say, "Joan taught me everything I know." Ring loved her grandchildren. Whenever she would travel to town, if she had $20, she would make sure all her grandchildren got something. Stacy recalled telling her very often, "Mommy, the children are good and they don't need anything." And of course, that fell on deaf ears. You can be sure something is in her bag for those children when she got home. She got satisfaction in giving them things she believed they needed. She then found memory of his grandmother, where one on her birthdays, she was dancing and singing with her hands in the air. It was a sight that made him smile. In addition to this, he remembered getting a puncture from a nail and his grandmother cleaning and wrapping his feet and trying her best to make him feel better. Shadera said he remembered the conversations he had with his grandmother during the vacation time. He would sit and talk with her about any and everything and for long periods of time. Shadera, the makeup artist in the making, would sometimes go over and make up her face with fake eyelashes and lipstick, making her look pretty in her own way. Ring enjoyed these moments with her sitting and patiently letting her do her thing with her face. Dario and Dwight recall coming home early in the morning after partying and Ring preparing breakfast for them. That was not all, lunches and dinners too. That was her way of showing her love. Carrie said, "My Aunt Ring took me to school on the first day and carried me through town showing me how to catch the bus. Living with her was like living in a jukebox. Wake up early to the sound of oldie goldies, and that was not all. Waking up in the middle of the night and hearing oldie goldies and Patrick on the radio." She said, "I believe there is not much oldies that I don't know now." Ring did not leave her siblings' children out. Whenever they came visiting, they would usually enjoy many talks and laughter with Ring, Janice, Lisa, and many others. They could always relate to Ring. even our family members and their little ones in the areas, the Browns and the Ways. You will usually hear, if you are in close proximity, them calling her for one thing or the other. Ring loved to keep memories of her loved ones close. If you had the privilege of going into her bedroom, and that wasn't often, you will see photos of family and friends displayed for all to see. And do not even think about asking her for any of them. It was always no. It would be a great error not mentioning the delight she got in preparing sauce every Saturday. You could guarantee that if you showed up on Saturday, that is what you would get. Mild or really hot sauce, whichever suited you. She loved to cook for the guys that usually come and hang out on a daily basis around the shop. If anyone asked, they would never refuse a plate of food. Prior to her passing, I recall her sitting next to the television and watching African movies after cooking. She would usually say, "Alfia, come," and she would proceed in giving me the rundown of the movie she was watching. It got me so hooked that when I get home, I would tell my children I'm going to Africa and proceed to watch them to myself. I can assure you, I can go on about the many ways Ring have impacted our lives and the many memories she would keep close to our hearts. I am also sure you too would have remembered something as I write to you, the different experiences she would have had with her. Unfortunately, time will not permit me to go any further. So today, we say goodbye to Ring, the cook, the singer, the dancer, the life of the party. We will miss you. Our family and the neighborhood will never be the same without you. Rest in peace until we meet again. Thank you.
Thank you, Sister Ellis, for that eulogy. While Dinah and Plus One prepare to render us a song, we want to recognize in the congregation at this time our Pastor Jordan from out of London and the delegation accompanying her, who themselves have come to share with the family in the time of mourning, having themselves last week Saturday laid to rest her sister. We also want to recognize the parliamentary representative for this area, Romel Springer. Can you stand that everybody can see who you are, sir? We want to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to come and to share with us in this final farewell to this lovely soul. At this time, Dinah Plus One is going to come and render us a song.
God gave life and he takes it away. He's the potter and I am the clay. When I view the last sunset,
we
Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. At this time, we invite Nadia Carter to read this evening's second lesson. Nadia Carter, I hope I have the pronunciation correct, to read Solo and Carter, Nadia Carter, solo.
Good morning again. Bless the Lord. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. Thank you.
Shall the church stand at this time? As we receive, Donna Carter is going to read the second lesson. Shall the church stand at this time?
Good morning. The second scripture is taken from Psalm chapter 23, and it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Here endeth the lesson.
Remain standing. Hallelujah. Of us, if in the celebration of this life that has passed, an invitation to you that don't know him as Savior should not be made through his word. And as Bishop Williams prepared to come to minister to you, we invite you through this song to hide yourself within the arms of the God who is able to take us through every storm of life.
I will be still and know you are God.
Of my mouth and the meditation of my heart will be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, for you are my strength and my redeemer. I give you praise and thanks in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Please have your seat if you can. on the behalf of the Church of God Worldwide Mission, I want to extend our deepest condolences to all of our family members. And we pray that the God of comfort will comfort you, and God will give you the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. I want to give God thanks for our Pastor Jordan, who are with us as well from the UK. Woman of God, my pastor, mother, friend, to Pastor David as well, and the sisters. Amen. To my wife and the children. See Bishop Farrell over there. Amen, Pastor Farrell, and all of the other pastors, Redmond, Joseph, there's so much, the elders over there, Britton Sill, Ebenezer, Bonwell, God bless you ever so much. And last but not least, to our parliamentary representative as well for this area. God bless you. Good to have you, sir, with us. Amen. The pastor did not say that. I will not know that. So good to have you. I want to talk to us today in brief from the book of Psalm 90 and verse 12. I think it's a familiar chapter. Psalm 90 and verse 12. And it reads like this: so teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. May God add his blessing to his word that is already being blessed. Not going to talk about my sister-in-law, because she's already been gone. And she was a good sister-in-law to me. We had a very good relationship, I must say. And I want to thank God for her life and the time that we share together. But even though that we know death eventually will come and all men will die, sometimes that death seems to be unfair, unnatural. And the reason for this is because that God has wired what we call eternity in the hearts of man. Our brain is wired with the thing that call life. Because understand that God is a God of life. The Bible said that he come that we might have life and have it more in abundance. In the beginning of the psalm, the psalmist wrote in the beginning of the psalm, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place throughout all generations. And he went on and he said, before the mountains were formed and the hills and the earth was formed and all of this, he said, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. I quote the scripture to us that we will understand that man is an everlasting being or creature. And even though that we will, according to the word, that the dust will go back to the dust. And when that time came and the heart stopped, and our life and earth is ended, I want to say to us, that does not end us. Amen, church. I listen to men that in ignorance, I can live as I like, I can do as I like, and when I die or dead, I done. But I beg to defer, because the word of God says it is appointed unto man. And I want church to hear me today. It's appointed unto man once to
die. But after this, there is a judgment. Every man in this house has an appointment with a thing that called death. Whether that we think about it or we don't think about it, one day we will all die. And it's not important, as I often say in prayers, how we come into the world. That is important. But it's a way that we are going to live. Because understand that the life that we live determines our eternal destiny. Early on, I told you that man is an eternal being. God made man in his own what? Image. And his own likeness. God is everlasting. God does not have a beginning. No, God does not have an ending. Man may have a beginning because eternity steps into time so that we have a beginning. Hallelujah. But where man is concerned, man will spend eternity either with the court of heaven, and you ain't gonna believe it, or in the place that we call hell. Because the Bible tells us or teaches us there is a heaven and there is a hell. Hallelujah. So the word of God tells us to number what? Our days. Look and see that the time is swiftly passing by. Life at best is brief. And if we understand that one day that we gotta face God, whether that we like it or we don't like it, whether we believe it or we don't believe it, the Bible is right. The Bible is right. Not sometimes, but all the time. If you go to the book of Corinthians, chapter 5, I believe, the Bible said that if our earthly house of this tabernacle being dissolved, we have a building, we have a house that is eternal in the heavens that made for us. And when you go on to verse 10, it tells us that we must all, A-double-L-all, appear before the judgment seat of Christ. And we must all, everyone in this house, give an account, because payday is coming. And we think that we can get away with God. There's a song that we used to sing every time, that God made a number, God know where I live, and God know how to find you. Because one scripture said, I think Psalm 139 or somewhere, he said, whither should I go from thy presence? If I ascend unto the hills, God is there. If I take the wings of the morning and I go where Pastor David, God is there. If I say to the darkness, come me, the darkness and the light means the same thing with God. So there is no getting away with God. So the word says we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, and we must all give an account whatever we've done in this life, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Just yesterday a man said to me, you're one of those people that serve the white man God. I didn't answer him. I didn't respond to him. Because God ain't a white man. Nor he ain't a black one either. God ain't pink. nor he any other. But God is, a spirit, and they that worship him must worship in spirit and in truth. And salvation is not about the white man either, or the black man, as some ignorance would say to us. Salvation is an experience. Got nothing to do with no color. The words of the wind blow it away. It listed. And you hear the sound. So is everyone. So is an experience. Why do you think that a man can live a reckless life, come into contact with Jesus, and bring about a change? It's an experience. Hallelujah. But I want to say to us, because I don't have much time to talk to you in funerals, but life at best is brief. The Bible tells us to number our days. You know why? We are strangers. We are pilgrims. We are foreigners. We are sojourners. We are travelers. We just passing through here. So we sit here and we build tabernacles as if that we're going to be here forever. But we're not going to be here forever, because this world in which that we live is not our home. One writer tells us that in a song, and in the book of Hebrews tells us that herein we have no continual city. But you know what? We seek one which is to come. Our fathers that has gone on before us, men like Abraham, looking down through the telescopic vision of time, and the Bible said he looked for a city which have foundation, whose builder and maker is God. Hallelujah. So I want to exhort us in my brief remark to you to make your calling an election sure. To understand that time clock, as somebody says, striking the hour. Hallelujah. And my in-law is gone. But guess what? All of us are in the house. Who's going to be next? We know. Anybody know? Nobody can put up their hands and say, well, I'm going to be the next. So why? The reason we don't know, because God does not give us that privilege to know. So you know what happened? In the book of Amos, I think verse chapter 4, verse 12, tells us, therefore, thus when I say unto thee, O Israel, O Hillaby, O Church of God, O people, because I will do this unto you, prepare to meet thy God. Yes. Hello, church. Because we got a meeting. And the word of God tells us, every knee shall bow. Come on, somebody. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And if we don't do it now, we gonna do it later. And Jeremiah said, when the harvest pass and the summer ending, and we are not safe, sad is gonna be your portion. But one way to ask the question, where are you gonna spend your eternity? One way or the other, you're gonna spend it place. Did I say man is eternal? Man is a spirit. He has a soul and he lives in a body. One day the spirit is going to go. James said the spirit without the body is dead, like my in-law. She is done with this life. As my wife said, you will never see her again in this life. But never think that is the end of her. It's not going to be the end. Somewhere in Revelation tells us, he that is holy must remain holy. And he that is filthy must remain. Because as a man lives, you didn't hear me. As a man lives, so shall he die. And there's not a place in Bible or nowhere that called power top that when you left this earth, you're going to get a second chance. There's no second chance. We're going to make our calling now. Today is the my sister sang about the love of God. God love us. God love us, church. God care about us. God concerned about us. The Bible said the whole what manner of love. When we were not lovable, the Father has bestowed upon us that we might be called sons of God. And somewhere in the word tells us, greater love, nobody can love you like Jesus. Have no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. And in my closing remark, to those of us that may be troubled in heart or in spirit, if you have a hope in God, let not your heart, you didn't hear me, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also. Because the word says, in my Father's house, there are what? My talk to me, many mansions. If it were not so, I won't say anything to you. But if I go, oh my God, I will come again. Oh my God, and I will receive you unto myself. So the church has a hope. The word that if in this life we have hope, we are as men most miserable. But one rather said that my hope is in the Lord. My hope is built. Jesus' blood and righteousness, I dares not trust the sweetest frame, but warning lean. But on Christ, the solid rock, I stand all at a drunks. I'm closing. My brother Job asked a question, if a man die, God, but all the days of my appointed time, I can wait until change come. Change is coming. This room of flesh, I drop, I rise, I decease the everlasting price. We have a hope. John said in Revelation, I saw a new heaven. God, we got to close this thing. God dwelleth there. And the Bible said that God himself shall wipe away all tears. No more pain. No more death. No more suffering. I'm closing. But the word said, I reckon. Symmetry for a certain time. So I recognize that I've got no time. But trust me, I feel I won't preach. Because I feel preaching. Hallelujah. Because that this thing about the coming of Christ excites me. Paul wrote in Thessalonians, and I'm closing here. Brethren, I would not have you to be ignorant concerning those that are asleep like my sister. For if you believe that Jesus died and rose again, those that God forbid, God will bring back with him. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, and we that are alive and remain shall be caught up. Somebody say caught up. Number our days so that we might apply our hearts to wisdom. The years of man is 70 and 10, and it by reason or strength that we will go over. God bless you. God encourage your heart. Come, do the last number, and then we're going to come back and do the closing. And then we continue the service at the cemetery. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord Jesus, I love you. Woo! Somebody say, woo! Woo! Thank you, Father.
Shall it just stand? Shall it just stand? It is well with my soul.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never. Worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before, your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on saying. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like worship your holy name. Bless you, time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, worship your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship his holy. Worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never. Worship your holy name.
thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness.
I'm in all of you. to the depths of the sea. Creation's revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring.
Yourself to me and Thou art, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son, not sparing, sent him to
by my side with more than you ever think or imagine. According to His power, working in us, standing in us, more than you ever think or imagine. Oh yeah, according to His power, working in us, standing in us. Let's go, yeah. Say it. It's more than you ever.
Thy face and are troubled. Thou takest away the breath, they die and they return to the dust. All go one place, all are dust, all turn to dust again. Jesus said that I'm the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us far more exceeding the weight of glory. While we look at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen, for the things that are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. For as much as it pleased the Almighty God, the God of mercy, to take back to himself the soul of our beloved daughter. We now commit the body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, and in sure and certain hope of the spirit which will be reunited to God, who give and will be reunited unto his. When Christ the Lord himself shall be descended from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, for the trump shall sound, and the dead shall rise incorruptible. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. Then shall be brought to pass the saying, as it is written, death is swallowed up into victory.
The song When We All Get to Heaven.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place.
Next hymn, In the Sweet By and By.
And the Father waits over the way.
the song Goodbye World.
Goodbye world, I stand no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin, I stand no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way. The rest, that's it. I made up my mind to go God's way. The rest of, come on, say it again, say it.
Song By and By, When the Morning Comes.
All the ways that God would lead us to that blessed
uncertain promised land, but he'll guide us with his eye, and we'll follow till we die. We will understand it better by and by. By and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we've overcome. We will understand it better by and by.
Oft our cherished plans have failed, disappointments have prevailed, and we've wandered in the darkness, heavy-hearted and alone.
But we're trusting in the Lord, and according to His word, we will understand it better by and by. By and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we've overcome. We will understand it better by and by. Temptations hidden snares often take us unawares, and our hearts are made to bleed for some thoughtless word or deed. And we wonder why the test, when we try to do our best. But we'll understand it better by and by. By and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God are gathered home, we will tell the story how we've overcome. We will understand it better by and by. We will understand it better by and by.
See, that's mom, cousin, and that's she uncle. So look at the face.
I can see.
Atop. Yeah, position there.
Got two more to learn.
Don't worry, anyway, come. Thank you.
one more. Yes.
Jen,
put
on it.
Just stick it in.
Let us pray. At this time, we want to pray for the family. Precious Lord, we thank you today for the life of Renola, your daughter that you loaned to us, and it has pleased you this day to take her with you. We pray now for the family she's left behind. The imprint of a love that she has left in their hearts. We know that comfort comes only from you. And you alone know how to comfort to the depths of our sorrows that no man can reach. Thus we pray, O God, that you will come by and you will comfort the family like only you can through your Son, Christ Jesus. We pray, dear Lord God, that the support that is needed, the understanding that is required, will be theirs to draw upon as this period of sadness and reflection is observed. We thank you for all those who have made it possible that they can come and share in this final moment of the family of Reniola Carter. So let your blessing now rest upon the family, to those that she has left behind. May your grace carry them through. These mercies we ask in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the blessed Holy Ghost. We, the pastors and family of the Church of God Worldwide Mission, want to thank all of you on behalf of the Carter family for being here today to share in this final moment of farewell. We want to thank you for all the messages of condolences that you have expressed in person or online, for your presence here today, and in any other way that you would have supported the family through this difficult period. We pray now that God will be with you and he will bless you. On behalf of the Carter's family and all the other families, Williams, etc., our many thanks and gratitude to you. God bless you. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the blessings of the Holy Spirit remain with us now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you.